Okay, and then cylinder head replace in this Toyota 2.2 liter engines. Okay, what we need? We need first this, what is specific tool. Now we need this longer socket, what fits in here in that way. Look, if we use that normal, and the size is 12 1/2 millimeter, and if we use that normal short socket, it is not enough deep, look, because we can't get contact in that cylinder head bolt what is in there and in here also, because this hole is so deep that this my short socket, it don't take contact to that bolt, and that's we need this longer socket for that bolt opening. Look, and this measurement is about 2 inches, and in centimeters about 5 centimeters. That is like 1 inch and 2.5 centimeters. And then remember, there must be those 12 corners in there inside. Look, in this socket, it must be 12 corner, because if we have only 6 corner, then we can't open this bolt. Okay. And we can get that kind of socket like in this US web page, this ebay.com, it is one what I can recommend, ebay.com. Okay, and then I insert my socket, and then we need a little bit longer bar, because these bolts are tight, and let's look at how I open like that bolt. I am in here, and then I move, and I have to take full power in this my hand, because this bolt is tight. Okay, and now it opens, and then again. Okay, good. This is ready, and then in here this second. Okay, and then I open all of these bolts, what are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10 bolts. And then when these bolts are open, we can continue that my cylinder head replace. Okay, and now when I have taken, I have loosened all of these bolts, then I can start to take these bolts out, so that I rotate that my tool in that way. Then this bolt opens, and let's look what this bolt looks like. Now it should be loosened, and then I need to use long tongs that I can insert my tongue in this hole, and then I can lift that bolt away. And there is this bolt. Okay, and this is only 26 years old Toyota's bolt, and looks very good shape. And then I take all of these another 10 bolts, actually 9 bolts away, and then we can try to test that, can I lift that cylinder head away. Okay. Okay, and now all of these my bolts are loosened, and now I only put my tongs, and I lift these bolts away. Okay, good. And there is my all bolts. And then when all bolts are free, I believe that I have to open at least one bolt in here. There is one 12 mm bolt in here. And I open that. I take this bolt away. And then in that side, in here, there soon seems to be one bolt left. Okay, good. And there was this small bolts that are in my hand. Okay, and now let's look at how I can take this cylinder head out, and it seems that it opens right away. Right away. Okay, it is actually moving. Very good. Very good. This seems that everything is fine, and then I can lift that. There are two hooks, and then remember, in that part we have to be really carefully, because there are those valve cups and this valve hats that are in this position, and these positions can drop easily to ground, that one, and there is thing that all of these gaps, they are just made for this some unique position. Like this gap, this fits only in that position. And do not ever mix these gaps, like that you take that away and install in here. Because then your valve system and your camshafts and valves, they are really noisy if we mix these parts. Okay, that's important thing. But now, when I lift that my cylinder head carefully, I can lift that so that there is one hook in here and second in here, and then I lift that away in that way. Okay, cool. Okay, and then we go to right away check that what is this my pistons situation. And like that cylinder 4, there is little bit corrosion, but not much. And then how about then this cylinder 1? There is something small corrosion, interesting. Maybe it corrosion, it came from that cylinder head, this gasket, cylinder head gasket, yes, there is this corrosion inside. Okay, and now I can take this, there is this old gasket, cylinder head gasket in here. Okay, yes, there is this cylinder head gasket in that material in inside. But pistons, they look good. And then we go to look, of course, that my this cylinder head, what is in there. Okay, let's look that what is this status. And now I carefully move that in this position, and then we can look that what is this cylinder head valve status, and everything looks very good. Look, only a little bit not much. Almost all valve and cylinder head areas, they are clean look, even that there is this plus 300,000 miles in this driving and 26 years this lifespan, and this 26 years old cylinder head, excellent quality. Okay. Nice part. Okay, now it's in there free.